Hi, I'm Jeff. Welcome to the Accessible Classroom. This is a video series where I review web accessibility tools and concepts and consider their use for the classroom. In this episode, I'm going to take a look at YouTube's closed captioning and consider how that can be used to support access to videos for those with hearing impairments. All right, so in your YouTube Creator Studio, get to the video that you want to add subtitles to and get into the edit interface. Right now, at this point in time, I could walk you through exactly what it looks like in YouTube, but this stuff is always changing from a user experience standpoint. So I'd rather just say, get to the video you want to edit, open up the edit panel, and find the subtitles and closed captioning option. And it'll look something like this. You have some options here. I always recommend starting with editing the automatically generated subtitles. So here you can go through and you can click edit. And this will allow you to modify any of the text. You can move it from line to line as you see fit. And you can also, let me just get rid of a couple of these so I can drag it around for you. You can change how long each section or each block of subtitles stay on the screen. So I always recommend starting with the automatically generated ones. And keep in mind that this doesn't have to be a complete transcription of what you say in your videos or what is being said in the videos by somebody else. In order to be accessible, videos need to have subtitles for the hearing impaired that equate to the same experience or a better experience than the mainstream way of consuming the video, which is to listen and to watch. And in a lot of cases, semantics in the way that we speak are not necessary or require more text to explain and to account for it in the subtitles. So, for example, if I say, hey everyone, my name is Jeff and welcome to the Accessible Classroom, maybe it's more appropriate for me to say, my name is Jeff. Maybe down here where I say accessibility as it relates to K-12 education, and I'm really excited to have conversations with you guys about web, blah, 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 blah. That's not really a conjunction, this and. That's the equivalent of a in my speech patterns. It's just a placeholder. So I can get rid of that. This will make a less confusing transcription experience for folks, and it doesn't devalue. If anything, it increases the value of this instructional aid. So you can save those changes when you're ready, and you're good to go. Your subtitles will be all set. Just make sure that you unpublish the auto-generated ones. And then that way your new file is there. You also have the opportunity to add subtitles in a different way. So you can go in and you can upload a file, you can transcribe and auto-sync, or you can create new subtitles or closed captionings from scratch. This transcribe and auto-sync is really good for if you don't have a script to feed through it or a subtitles file to feed into there. If you recorded your video and you just talked without a script, this is really great because you can press play.
Hey everyone, my name is Jeff.
And it will pause as you type.
And welcome to the Accessible Classroom.
So that way it allows you to keep up with the video without having to pause and start and pause and start as you're transcribing. So this is really good. Then you can go through and you can set your timings. And it will automatically set the timings for you. And then you can go in and edit that once those are set. So here it is, it's set. And now I have this interface that looks a lot like the new subtitle option, where I can go in and I can double check the timings that YouTube set for me. All right, thanks for watching this episode on YouTube closed captioning. Let me know how you're using this feature with students and staff, whether it be with YouTube or doing video closed captioning with something different. See you next time.